need corpuscular values. We corpuscular values. These values are very important when evaluating the red blood cells, and these values are used to classify the anemia according to the size and according to the stain. Also called the white corpuscular indices, and include three parameters. Number one, white corpuscular volume. White corpuscular volume, or called the MCV. Number two, white corpuscular hemoglobin, or called MCH. Number three, mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration, or called MCHC. Number one, which is the mean corpuscular volume, is used to classify the anemia according to the size. Number two and number three, MCH and the MCHC, used to classify the anemia according to the amount of hemoglobin and concentration of hemoglobin, or according to the stain of the red blood cells. Number one, MCV. MCV, or mean corpuscular volume, is the average, reflects the average size of a single red blood cell, and obtained by dividing the BCV on the red blood cell count. Red blood cell count per deciliter, obtained by the MCV, is obtained by dividing the BCV in person on the red blood cell count per deciliter. It is so the result here is expressed in femtoliter. As we know, 1 liter is equal to 10 power 15 femtoliter. This because 1 liter equal to 1000 milli, and 1 milli equal to 1000 microliter, and the microliter equal to 1000 nanoliter, and the nanoliter equal to 1000 picoliter, and the picoliter equal to 1000 femtoliter. So the 1 liter equal to 10 power 15 femtoliter. For example, if our blood cell count equal to 5 gigaliter, and the BCV equal to 30%, then how we can calculate the AB corpuscular volume according to this equation? The ABCV will equal to BCV divided into the red blood cell count in gigaliter. So using the values mentioned above, ABCV will equal to 30% divided into 5 gigaliter. Or you can write it as 0.30 divided into 5 multiplied by 10 power 12. So the result here will be 30 divided into on 5. The result will be 30 divided on 5 multiplied by 10 power 14, which will be equal to 6 divided into 10 power 14. So this result will equal to 60 multiplied by 10 power minus 50. Because 1 liter is equal to 10 power 15 femtoliter, then femtoliter would equal to 10 power minus 15 liter. So this will be 60 femtoliter. 60 femtoliter. MCV in this example will be 60 femtoliter. So first we divide the BCV on the red blood cell count in gigaliter. The BCV in this example is 30%, and the red blood cell count is 5 multiplied by 10 power 12 gigaliter. So the final calculation would be 60 femtoliter. 60 femtoliter. Number two. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin is defined as the amount of hemoglobin or weight of hemoglobin in a single red blood cell, obtained by dividing the hemoglobin concentration gram per liter divided into the red blood cell count in gigaliter, and the result would be expressed in picogram. Picogram. Also, as we know, the 1 gram equal to 1,000 milligram. 1 milligram equal to 1,000 microgram. 1 microgram equal to 1,000 nanogram, and 1 nanogram equal to 1,000 picogram. So, gram will equal to 10 power 12. Picogram. So for example, if you have a blood sample with a red blood cell count five gigaliter, and the hemoglobin concentration equal to 100 gram per liter. So how we can calculate the MCH? The MCH will equal to the hemoglobin concentration 100 divided into the red blood cell count. So it will be 20 divided into 10 power 12. T equal to 20 multiplied by 10 power minus 12, so it will be 20 picogram. 20 picogram. This is the MCH in this example. The third value for the mean corpuscular values or mean corpuscular indices is the MCHC. The MCH used to calculate the amount or weight of hemoglobin in a single red blood cell. The mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is used to calculate the concentration or percent of hemoglobin in a single red blood cell. The MCHC is calculated by dividing the hemoglobin concentration gram per liter on the BCV percent. So, for example, if we have a blood sample with a hemoglobin concentration equal to 120 gram per liter, a gram per liter, and we have a BCV equal to 30%, then the MCHC will equal to the hemoglobin concentration 120 divided into 30%. So the result will be 120 divided into 30. The result will be 120 multiplied by 100 divided in 30. So when dividing this will be 4 multiplied by 100 gram per liter. It will be 400 gram per liter. 400 gram.